Hey Stringies, how are you doing? There's something I want to discuss that some of you might have already been wondering about. It's something that's been lacking in my channel, and I'm talking about orchestral covers. Or more specifically, the Mini Mario Orchestra. What happened? Let me tell you. It's been more than 2 years since I last posted a proper Mini Mario Orchestra video, and the reason for that is basically Nintendo. I'm pretty sure you've all heard about the news when Nintendo started copyright claiming and even copyright striking Nintendo-related videos on YouTube. And it started roughly 2 years ago in 2015, and Nintendo was so aggressive in removing any trace of Nintendo fan content on YouTube. And one of the biggest musical casualties of this was one of my favorite channels, Pokemon Orchestrated. They basically tore down the channel and now it's gone from YouTube. Although the arrangements are still available elsewhere. But it's really a tragedy for me as a musical artist and as a YouTuber that Nintendo does this kind of treatment to their fans. And there are so many sides of the argument that they say that Nintendo has the right to do this because they own the copyright. And the other side is Nintendo should not be erasing fan creations because it also promotes their content, like free promotion or something. I can understand both sides of the argument, and I really have nothing concrete to say about that topic at this time. So instead, I will just focus on how it affected me and my channel. Around 2 years ago, I posted a vlog saying that I'm taking a break from Nintendo covers. And the reason that I gave is basically something related about Nintendo's copyright thing. But what I didn't tell you is what I'm going to tell you now. To be honest, I never wanted to stop making Nintendo covers, but Nintendo's policy really broke my heart. It really made me lose enthusiasm to make Nintendo covers, to make any Nintendo-related content on my channel. Just like a lot of you, my childhood is so much ingrained with Nintendo culture, Nintendo games, Nintendo characters, that Nintendo is essentially a part of me, a part of who I am, a part of my childhood, a part of my life. So making Nintendo covers is really important for me. But when Nintendo started doing those copyright claims and those copyright strikes on several fan creations over the internet, I paused for a while and started to think that, hey, I should be careful with what I post now if it's Nintendo related because I might be the next victim of Nintendo's aggressive copyright strikes. And so I made that vlog about not making Nintendo covers. So yeah, I feared for my channel. I feared that I would lose everything that I built up here in my YouTube channel just because of Nintendo's aggressive copyright approach. So I decided that time that I won't be making any Nintendo covers for a while I take a step back and see what happens. So for those 2 years, I was taking a wait and see approach and see if Nintendo would do anything in my channel because a lot of the stuff that I posted in my early YouTube career have been mostly Nintendo covers and a lot of my most viewed covers are Nintendo covers. And during that waiting period, Nintendo even released a game and would you know it, called Mini Mario and Friends. And that made me even more nervous because Nintendo could possibly say that, hey, the phrase Mini Mario is now a phrase that is copyrighted to us. So we're gonna take you down and blah 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 and all that. So that was really a tense moment for me and I was waiting to see if they would do something about that in my channel, in my content, and all my Mini Mario Orchestra videos. And now we're close to 2 years of that and thankfully, Nintendo did not take any negative action towards my channel, towards my content, and I really hope they don't. But I guess that's enough waiting time for me to decide that, hey, I guess it's kind of safe for me to post these kinds of content again. And so I've decided that the Mini Mario Orchestra will be making a comeback in my channel. And I have big plans again, but I don't want to discuss it yet because I want it to be a surprise. And of course, during the time when I skipped on orchestral covers, I experimented a lot of other types of arrangement, which led me to the violin rock/violin metal format that I've been using recently. and it opened up the doors for me to cover other video game franchises. I especially loved your reaction to my Undertale covers, my Mega Man Violin Metal covers, even my Sonic covers. So yeah, thanks guys. I really thank you for tolerating my so-called experimental arrangement phase during that time. But since I've also grown to love these new formats, I will be mixing it up with the violin metal covers, violin rock, orchestral covers, acoustic covers, and the occasional a cappella cover as well. It will all be filling my channel. So yeah, now that you've heard the full story, I'm also interested to hear what you guys think. What type of new arrangement formats do you want to hear? Are you excited for orchestral covers again? Do you want me to make more of these violin metal formats, acoustic formats, a cappella covers? Do you want to hear them all, or do you want to hear just one style, or do you want me to keep on experimenting? Let me know what you think in the comments. And of course, please check out the fan art contest that I'm hosting. It will be ending on August 31. You still have time to join that. And also, please stay tuned for the final Undertale album, which I'll be releasing on September. It's going to be the complete edition. Also, I'm already starting plans for the 2017 VGM compilation album, so watch out for that. And what else did I forget? Oh yeah, are you also interested to see new types of content in my channel aside from music content? Do you want to see me do Let's Plays? Do you want me to do tutorials or something? Or Q&As or more Q&As, something like that? Let me know in the comments. And finally, my last question to you, would you be interested to join if I host a cover competition? Because I've been so inspired by the competitions held by Insane in the Rain Music and Rishad EB, and some other of my YouTuber friends have been hosting these music competitions in their channel. And I'm also interested to know if you guys would be interested if I host a contest myself. So let me know. So yeah, I think I've rambled quite enough for now. So I'll see you soon, guys. Stay awesome, Stringies.